time ever, the Bola Bola show. We turun stadium today to watch the game. So guys, how you guys are feeling? Feeling what's your anticipation of tonight?
You know, feeling... Wachi bang! Okay, there you go. That was a cool guy selling the Wachi. I mean, feeling excited, you know, watching, able to see the floodlights, you know, the stadium floodlights again, exactly, although now exactly. In the dark lah.
Back.
This kind of...
So, there you go.
That's what
I'm talking about. You know, it's been a long, long time since we actually, you know, and go under the floodlights. So, you know, really looking forward to this, man.
Yeah. It's been a while, guys.
I think it's going to be a JDT win, but very, very slim win by a single goal.
For me, I think after the what happened, the Terengganu game, this is going to be a backlash. 3-0.
3-0 to whom?
JDT.
JDT. Okay, I'm going to pick a 2-0 win to JDT. All right. Yeah. Let's see who gets it correct.
All right.
All right.
Oh, watch this, man. Watch this.
We're entering just.
Pitch right.
Just when we're entering inside the stadium. Basically the JDT zone. There's no doubt about it.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Let's look for a seat.
Yeah.
What's your comment on the first half?
The first half actually was a bit flat. I mean, overall you see JDT, I think having maybe 70% possession, you know, having the ball, but they weren't going anywhere. You know, you see them taking the ball, controlling the ball and all that, but just cannot break through KL. And then we see that KL is set up for the counter.
Mm-hmm.
Remember at the beginning itself, I saw the JDT line was very high, the defensive line, and all it takes is just a high ball and like what we just saw, you know, that's how KL struck them with a goal. So second half is going to be very interesting. We are seated and positioned right behind.
Yes, as you can see, JDT will be attacking this direction. Yep.
Yeah. So I suppose this is going to be the goalpost with full of action. But what do you think, Bala?
I think first and foremost, I think kudos to KL team. They perfectly defeated to the tactical side. Having said that, I think the problem will be the second half. I think it's right after. I just speaking to Fulham that scoring at our half time is very dangerous. So they just did that. Let's see what's going to happen. I think JDT will be pumped up, especially the first half of Terengganu. And let's see. It's going to be interesting second half. How about you, Sivan?
Yeah, Sivan, what about you, man?
I mean, for me, I have to agree with you guys. Overall, you know, JDT was keeping the ball, but you know, I don't see that. That very all important penetration that should result in a goal, that wasn't really happening. Of course they had chances, you know, they hit the bar, they had chances, but overall, you know, they really need to improve on the attack. That's just my view. But I don't know, let's see what
but this sure, you know, sets us up for a great second half, man.
Yeah, now I can only feel that coach Benjamin Mora, I mean, he's tremendously, I don't know whether he's tremendously under pressure or what, you know, having lost the previous game against Terengganu.
Yeah.
Definitely.
And
some JDT has to do something.
Yeah, and you can imagine guys what the Terengganu and Kedah fans and all that are actually thinking now, because they are just few points, like two, 3 points behind JDT, and for them they will hope this result stays. And the league is gonna be wide open.
I think Terengganu fellas can go on top, I think, if they win a nice game.
Terengganu is playing tomorrow against Pahang, I'm mistaken. Kedah is currently leading 1-0 Melaka. So, you know, I think by this weekend we might have a very interesting league table at the top.
Yeah. So there you have it, guys. All good times in the league, and you know, let's look forward to the second half.
But then also,
Bala, you want to add something?
Yeah, I think the one thing, I have kudos to the fans and also to the officials here. I think everybody maintain a social distance. I think very safe here, and I think it's a very comfortable environment. I think we can confidently bring our children, our family people to come. Of course, social distancing is very good. A lot of people asking us to sit down. So I think I think the fans can come and watch a good game with a safe environment. Like I done that.
In the end, I think it was a very fair result, I would say. You know, JDT might feel short-changed or something like this, but KL fought very hard and earned the hard-fought draw. I would put it this way. As for JDT, well, you know, the pack is catching up behind them, so it really makes the league very interesting now. So, you know, congratulations, basically, to KL, the KL team, for this hard-fought draw. Yeah.
What about you, Bala?
I think they played well, like all Alvin said. But I think that tactically they did very well for the mid-table. Kudos to them. And I think Johor is a very good team, but seems they're not invisible as what we thought to be.
And yeah.
So I think it's a kind of challenge for where they go after this. Like what Alvin said, you know, the pack is catching up. Perhaps anything can happen in the league.
And just want to add one more thing. Bergson was an invisible man today. You know, he was nowhere to be seen, and all the hype about him and all this, you know, kind of fell flat because, you know, on the way when we were coming here in the car, we thought, okay, you know, we're going to really get to see this guy in action. So we hope that, you know, he bounces back from this as well and hope to see more from him. What about you, Sivan?
Well, like what you guys say is a fair result. I think KL deserved their 1 point. And pressure is going to be on JDT, you know, because it's two games in a row not winning. So, like what you say, everybody's catching up on them, you know. It's going to be interesting to see how they respond in the next game from here. So, look forward to Terengganu's game tomorrow. Let's see what they can do.
Yeah.